Children, today we'll continue to the last part, that is biodiversity, that is last part of the lesson, biodiversity and its conservation, right? So if you see measures of saving flora and fauna, flora means, you know, plants, yes, flora and fauna is the animals, right? Now what if you see, why they have to be saved is, they should not be lost from the earth surface. Right? They should not be lost from the earth surface. That's the reason we have to save the flora and fauna. Yes? And it can be done by certain steps. By certain steps of conservation. The flora and fauna can be saved by certain steps of conservation, right? Now for this, in our country, if you see, in our country, the forest area is demarcated as plants and animals, they are saved in the form of national sanctuaries, reserve forest, parks and national parks. Okay, now let's study what are these national parks. This national park is a very big area, a vast area, you can say big area or a vast area of a forest that is hedged to conserve the wild animals or the wildlife, that is the wild animals, in the natural habitat. That is called as national park, natural habitat. So here what happens is, no grazing is also allowed. So grazing of animals is also not allowed, and it is completely a prohibited area, right? So no human activity in any form is not allowed. Human activity in any form is not allowed, and I told you grazing of animals is also not allowed. So if you see the example, it is a completely prohibited area. So where no one is allowed, prohibited area. So if you see there, it will be written prohibited areas, it will be written. That means no person can go there and do any form of human activity. For example, that is Jim Corbett National Park, that is present in Nainital, Uttarakhand. Sanctuary is a place where the wildlife is protected. In its natural habitat. Allowing limited human activity. Okay. So in national parks, it was totally, they won't allow any human activity, but here they allowing limited human activity. So limited human activity is allowed. Right? That's the difference between national park and national sanctuary. That is the sanctuaries. So if you see here, example is Pakkal Sanctuary. Pakkal Sanctuary, that is there in Warangal. Yes, this is a bird sanctuary, Pakkal Bird Sanctuary, right? It's a bird sanctuary which is present in Warangal. Teddy, what is the importance of biodiversity and its biodiversity conservation, right? So without biodiversity, we will perish. We will perish. And the second is the biological, the food webs will be, the food webs will be disturbed. So if the food webs are disturbed, the organisms will become, the organisms will become endangered. Yes or no? Endangered. So when the organisms become endangered, what will happen? And they become extinct. And later, once they become endangered, then they slowly they may become extinct, and that particular species will be lost from the nature. Importance of biodiversity in a country like India, is that it meets the needs of the people of India in some way or the other. That is survival needs. Needs means what? The survival needs of the people of India. So if biodiversity is not there, the survival needs will not be fulfilled, and they will not live in a proper way. Sometimes some birds live in the same habitat throughout the life. But if you see some birds, they move from one place. To another in flocks. That is in small flocks. So such birds are called as, such movement is called as migration. That is, movement of the birds from one place to another is called as migration, and the birds are called as migratory birds. You see, during rainy season the birds from Kolleru and Pulikete. Birds from the Kolleru and Pulikete lakes, they migrate from one place to another. From faraway places, they migrate to Kolleru and Pulikete lakes of our state. That is birds from different places. They migrate to Kolleru and Pulikete lakes, okay, and they build their nest in the nearby villages. But nowadays, what is happening? Most of the people are cutting the trees. So when they are cutting the trees, what is happening? The habitat of the birds is lost. So when the habitat of the birds is lost, they are not able to build their nest, and we are also not able to see different kinds of birds in a state. You see, the Siberian crane, which migrates from Russia to India during the winter season, okay, and that migrates for food, shelter, protection and reproduction, and also during adverse atmospheric conditions. And such birds, it migrates from one place to another place for the food, shelter, protection and reproduction, is called as migratory birds. migratory birds. So if you give an example of migratory birds is the Siberian crane, which migrates from Russia to India. Study about the recycled paper. So we see we write many things on the paper. Often we waste more paper than we write. Incompletely written paper or scribbled ones are usually wasted. We should use the paper very swiftly. Papers are valuable products made from a green source. Ton of paper, 17 trees have to be cut down. So wasting of paper or using more paper means felling more number of trees. That is cutting down more number of trees, causing deforestation. So using more paper involves using more chemicals that are harmful to us and nature. The paper can be reused by recycling it 5 to 7 times. This will help in protecting the trees. So now we'll see what are the things needed and how paper recycling can be done. To see to prepare the recycled paper, the materials required is 2 plastic tubs, wooden spoon, then we need water, clean cotton cloth, then old newspapers, wire screen is needed, a measuring cups, plastic wrap, blender, the roller and heavy books are needed. Now coming to the procedure, first you have to cut the newspaper, any newspaper whatever you have, and soak it in a day, soak it for a day in a tub of water. So you should pour plenty of water and soak it. Now place 2 cups of the soaked paper, that is whatever you soaked it for one day, take that and add 6 cups of water in a blender. Then blend it, make it into a form of a pulp, and then transfer the pulp in a tub, in a clean tub. Now what you have to do is lay a cloth on a flat waterproof surface. On a surface you put the cloth, then you have to slide the wire screen over it under the wet pulp. Place the pulp and then you have to put the wire screen. Yes, now remove the screen slowly. You just remove the screen from the below the paper pulp. Then you press the pulp to squeeze the extra water. So when you squeeze, what will happen? It will become little hard. Earlier it was like a soft pulp. Now when the water is removed, it will become into a thick sheet like structure. Now what you have to do is carefully flip the screen on the cloth. Okay, with the pulp. That is, you had the pulp. Then press it down firmly. Now after pressing the pulp on the cloth, you have to remove the screen slowly. Now lay another cloth on the top of the mixture. So whatever pulp is there, on that you have to put another cloth, and then cover it with a plastic wrap. So cover the cloth with plastic wrap and stack the books on the wrap. So you have to put down, you have the cloth, then you have the pulp, then again you have the cloth, then under that you have to keep the books. When you stack, what will happen? Due to the heavy weight, it will get fixed. Books on the wrap. After several hours, remove the books on the cloth and let the paper dry. So once the paper get dries, you have to you can put some edible colors so that the paper can become more colorful. And then you can just press the new made paper and you can cut into different shapes and you can make beautiful greetings or whatever you want. Okay, that is the bags, and then file covers you can make out of it. Existence of biodiversity. So in nature, it teaches us, what does it teach? That each and every organism, whether it is useful or not, okay, every organism is important. So you can see the existence of biodiversity. It teaches that every organism, whether it is useful or not, is important. Okay, it has important, and it has a right to exist. It has a right to exist, right? It teaches that it is very important and it has a right to exist. Every organism, again if you see, every organism is a part of an ecosystem. Yes, and if you see an ecosystem, if any organism is destroyed in an ecosystem, the food chain and the food web is disturbed. If the food chain and the food web is disturbed, that will have an effect on the ecosystem, right? That ecosystem will be changed, altered. That's the reason that biodiversity should be protected. Conservation. when we say conservation of biodiversity means, it is the right use of the forest resources. It is the rightly you have to use what? The right use of the natural resources. Natural resources or the forest resources. You can say natural resources or the forest resources, right? And you should judiciously use it without affecting the ecosystem. So it should not affect whom? The ecosystem should not be affected, so that then only you can do the conservation of the biodiversity and we can have a sustainable development of the biodiversity. So nature is for humans' need. Yes, it's for humans' need. So human is only a part of nature, right? So he is not the whole. So human being is only a part of the nature. So humans are only a part of nature. They are not as a whole, right? Part of nature. So we think the nature is us, but nature has other things also, the plants, animals, wild animals and plants. So human beings should know to conserve the plants, animals and judicially use the nature, then only you can conserve the biodiversity. I hope you have understood, children. Thank you.